Welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be talking about this is the new Samyang 85mm f1.4 MF, so manual focus Mark II lens. So actually the Mark II version of a relatively popular lens already. This is an interesting lens for a few different reasons. First and foremost, I think, because it's an incredibly accessible portrait lens for photographers who are just starting out, maybe beginners, someone who wants to get a portrait lens, their first portrait lens. This is a very affordable option. I'll pop a link so you can go and check the price and full specs and all that kind of stuff down in the description. But this is an incredibly useful thing for a kind of beginner and starter out photographers. Now, of course, it's manual focus, which is a little bit more difficult at 85mm, especially if you're shooting wide open, f1.4. It's a little bit more difficult than, say, using eye autofocus, which is an extremely useful thing to have. This is available for Canon EF mount, Nikon F mount, and Sony E mount. So I was using it with Sony cameras, so the a7 III and the a7 R4. Now, I think it's fair to say, I probably have come to rely a little bit too much on the Sony eye autofocus. You know, obviously in the past I've used monofocus quite a lot and stuff like that, but with the Sony cameras, the eye autofocus is so ridiculously good. It's very easy to fall back on it and use that pretty much all the time, especially for portraits. So it was actually quite nice to go back to a manual focus lens and have to do it myself. That was a nice kind of fun thing. That's just a personal thing, but I enjoyed it. I enjoyed using the manual focus and actually feeling like I wasn't just nailing the focus instantly at the press of a button all the time. I actually had to work a little bit for it, which is, it's kind of a fun thing to actually try out. Now, f1.4, of course, gives you very nice shallow depth of field, and the bokeh here is very soft, and I think looks really, really nice. I think it looks really lovely, and I think the colors from this lens as well, I very much noticed that when I came to actually edit the photos. I think they look superb. I think they look really nice, and there's a good bit of contrast with this lens as well. Now, it's actually the same optics as the previous version of the lens, but there have been some significant updates to the actual kind of feel, the build of the lens. And you can feel that as soon as you kind of hold it. It feels good in the hands. It's obviously more of a metal construction. You know, there's a little bit of a weight to it, although I must say it pairs basically perfectly with those Sony cameras. It sits on the front and the weighting is great. It's not super front heavy. It feels nice. The lens is big enough that you can have your hand round it and comfortably use the focus ring, but you still get your other hand. It's not too big. It's just a lovely, lovely setup to actually use. I didn't check it out with the Canon or the Nikon, but I imagine it's pretty similar. Now, actually on the lens itself, you've got an aperture ring, which you can de-click as well to have it smoother if you want to use this for video, which is a nice thing. I think 85mm is actually a pretty useful focal length for some kind of video shot. It can be very cinematic. You can get nice kind of B-roll stuff with it. I think it looks great. So having the option to de-click, very, very useful. I'll have it clicked most of the time because I'll probably use this more for photography, but it's a nice thing to have on there. The actual focus ring as well, much like on the 14mm, which we've also done a video on, the focus ring feels really good. It's weighted pretty much perfectly, I would say. Not too kind of damp to turn, but certainly not too loose either. It just feels good. And something which is nice, got a hyperfocal scale actually on the lens as well, which is a nice thing to have on a manual focus lens as well. It's kind of a nice extra little touch there as well. Now, of course, this is a little bit more of a heavy weight to this focus ring than we found on the 14mm. And that's because you want to probably, especially at f1.4, or even if you were f1.8 or something like that, if you're trying to nail focus on the eye for a portrait, you are going to want to be making very small adjustments to the focus. So having it weighted a little bit heavier is great because it just allows you to make those small adjustments without accidentally going too far and things like that. Now, I think this is an incredibly good option for someone wanting to get into portrait photography, wanting to try it out without spending a huge amount of money on something like a G Master lens or a Sony or something like that. You know, those are incredible lenses, but you can get a lot of these lenses for one of them. And that's probably partly the point. So if you want to go check it out, I'll pop a link down in the description so you can check out everything, all the full spec, pricing, all that kind of stuff. Of course, if you want to learn more, pop a question down in the comments. I feel like this has been a pretty quick little review. I don't really have much more to say other than I actually really like the lens. It feels good to shoot with. I think the images coming out of it are actually really nice. Colors, bokeh, all that kind of stuff. I think it looks really nice. There is the kind of trade-off of it is manual focus, which can be a little bit trickier, especially at this kind of focal length and this kind of depth of field. But, you know, for this price point, this is an incredibly accessible 85mm portrait lens, which is a really, really nice thing. Now, like I say, any questions, pop them down in the comments below. I'll get back to you ASAP. Of course, if you like the video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe as well, because we've got loads of stuff all the time, tutorials, reviews, all the stuff you could want. I will see you in the next video. And as always, thanks for watching.